session on using the equipment in the venues. These venues were upgraded about 2 or 3 years ago. And the idea was to basically have a system that is user friendly, that you don't need to call ABS out and do, you know, like I was a student here as well, and back in the day we used to have the overhead projectors, and there was always a problem with overhead projectors coming to a lecture venue, and then there's no overhead projectors and things like that. But now they've centrally installed a system that is called the Crestron system. And so most of the venues, whether you're teaching or lecturing in the A block, in the B block, and I'll show you some of the other venues that's also upgraded with this facility, they more or less work the same. I don't know if any of these any lecturers maybe from the dentistry faculty at Tigerberg, they don't have the system now, right? So something similar, some of the other campuses. So some of the equipment and hardware that we go through, they might differ from venue to venue, but essentially the basics are more or less the same. Okay? So just by means of introduction, just gonna go through some of the hardware upgrades that's been done. Okay, so before there never used to be any of this overhead projectors or the LCD projector rather in the venues. So this is completely new. They've got one stationed in most of the venues. Then they've got these computers that's installed, especially for those lectures who don't want to carry the laptops along with them to the venues. Some lectures actually prefer to do so. And if you do want to use your own laptop, there's provision made for that as well. And then we've got the document camera. You might have seen this. The document camera essentially just replaces your overhead projector. So if you still want to, you know, maybe one of the old school issues, you've still got transparencies because you've got notes from a couple of years back and you still want to use that, you can also use that with the document cameras. It doesn't necessarily mean that you have to throw them away. All it means is that this is a camera, and it takes a picture of or an image of whatever it is that you place on this particular surface of video. Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through a slide presentation showing you just the various procedures, various functions of the Crestron, and then after that we're going to have a little go run and allow you to do some hands-on with the Crestron if you're not familiar with it. Okay? So essentially the Crestron is a touchscreen device. It looks like a panel like most of the panels that you get in your ATMs where you have to, you know, draw money and things like that, except you can't draw money from this machine. Okay, this is just to switch between the various devices. All computing and AV devices in the room are connected to the Crestron. Like I said, we've got the document camera, there's also a DVD player, and they are locked up at the moment. So if you want to make use of your DVD player, you can get the keys from AVS. But in most cases, most lecturers prefer to use the built-in DVD player that comes in your computer setup as a video. Okay? And these are some of the venues that you can look forward to using the Crestron system. It's the A1, so it's everything that's in the A block, the C block, the B block, it's this building. And then we also have in the EC buildings that they've got some equipment installed. Okay, firstly, how to use the Crestron. Now, when you come to the lecture, most often, most of the things will already be switched on, so you really don't need to worry about that in most cases. But if you should come and you find that this is a black screen over here, don't be alarmed. It doesn't mean that it's shut down or it's not working. All you need to do is touch it and the screen will light up, okay, with all the various functions on it. And that is essentially your first thing that you will get. So you can, as you can see, you've got different settings over here. You've got one for the DVD, you've got one for the projector, the document camera. The aircon, unfortunately, back in the day, you used to be able to control the aircon, and sometimes students complain that the venue is too cold or too hot. Unfortunately, there's no way you can control the air condition in this particular venue. It's centrally controlled, okay? And then the lights, you can override the lights. And I'll show you when we do the practical demonstration how, with each device that you're working with, this equipment that you're working, the lights adjust automatically. You can override those presets just by clicking on the lights and adjusting the lights manually, okay? So you can choose amongst those settings. Select the computer, obviously you're going to use the computer, that's the one that you're going to be using. You will click on computer. If you're going to use desktop, you have the option of using a desktop or a laptop. For instance, if you know you're going to have a guest lecturer or a guest presenter coming in, and they prefer making use of their own laptop, maybe they have a Mac or something like that that they want to use, then you have a setting on the side, on the panel, you can get a table from AVS as well. If you don't have one, you get the laptop cables that you can connect to this, and that allows you to make use of an external laptop, and then you'll have to choose and select the laptop setting over here rather than the desktop to operate. Okay, the built-in PC is really very simple. If not switched on, the very first thing that you need to do, if everything is switched off, you come into a lecture maybe in the morning and you find that your LCD projector is off, you're going to start it up from here, from your touchscreen. Now the LCD projector is the only device, piece of equipment, that you will start up from here. Everything else you'll have to do manually. Okay? So if I want to use the document camera, I'm going to have to switch it on this on switch over on this side. If the computer's off, I'll have to turn it on manually. The only thing that you need to turn on with a press is the LCD projector. Okay? So that would be the first thing obviously that you turn on, is the projector. It takes a while to do, maybe a couple of seconds before you see the lamp heating up and then projecting something on the screen. And then of course, if the computer is not started up already, you have to get a login. Okay? And you can see here, the username is just user, and the password, I don't know if you're familiar with the password, but let me just do something here. The password is ABE selected, okay? So you don't divulge that information to your students or anything. It's normally just meant for the lectures, and it's spelled like this, let me see.
Desktops will be, workstations will be checked.
Yes. For instance, look, if you're using the e-learning system, the only the learning management system is the web page. So you can still use your desktop. Okay, you don't need to switch or change anything. Okay. If you're going to be using your DVD, like I said, most people prefer using the DVD setting that's in your computer, you use it as per normal. Right? You get your DVD disc, if it's a presentation you want to do. This computer is hooked up to the sound in the meeting so that you don't need additional speakers. The same applies when you use your laptop. You probably need an additional jack cable. It's also here. You see the setting over here, there's a jack over here, you can pick your audio cable, and that allows the audio from your laptop to go through the system. Okay, again, once you've selected your DVD, you can control it from the Crestron as well. That is all that means. You get your volume, you can skip to the next page. But I find that very few lectures actually make use of it. They prefer using it in computer itself. Then the document camera. Then you can see you get various types of document cameras. They differ from venue to venue. Some of the settings, the knobs here in front, is maybe you'll find in the back, somewhere over here. But they all more or less look the same. These little arms here on the side is just to project some light onto the subject. This over here will be your camera. Okay? So anything. What it allows me to do is, if I was going to add something printed out like this for my class, and before I actually handed out to them, I wanted to go through it with them, I can put this on here, you know, and it will essentially project it on the screen for you, okay? But before we need to do that, you obviously need to switch from a projector, from my PC at least, over to my document camera, and we're going to do that practically in a moment. So that's the document camera. Again, these are some of the menus. We'll find these document cameras. The arms, you can see this, the example that's on screen. This is an example of a document camera. You'll find in some of the other menus where you have a red or blue light which indicates that the projector is on or off. here, as I said, if you want to use a document camera, very easy, you just have to select the document camera on the screen. Some of the venues, I don't know if it works in this venue, you can also say whether the lecture is in progress or not. Some venues do not have it, but you do have that option. And then, as I said, the lights, you can override by just clicking the light switch. Also, you see some of this. I think that one is not one day in the passage. You have a device picker like this. So if for any reason you're not going to be using your computer, you may be using, you know, your whiteboard, for example, you can still override the lights using that particular switch on the board. And then using of microphones, I don't know how many people actually make use of microphones these days. You do? Is it? Yeah, so I mean, like if you need a microphone or something like that, you can order one from AVS as well. And I'll give you all the contact details at the end of this particular slide. Presentation. It's all set up already. All you need to do is get the headset from them and come into your venue, and it will be activated automatically. Okay, they will do that for you. Okay, and then after your lecture, in most cases, people don't bother, but especially at the end of the day, if you know that you're the last, you know, because these lamps are very expensive to replace, and maybe in the next in a week's time or so, the lamps will be out, you come to the venue and you want to use it and it's not working. So turn off as far as possible, turn off whatever you've used. Maybe if you've used the document camera, just switch it off again. Remember that happens manually. If you want to switch off the LCD projector, you have to do it via the keystroke. If you borrow keys from the AVS department, please make sure that you return it again to them. Lock up everything that needs to be locked up. Because otherwise, you know, these devices, they grow feet, and the next morning you come out, they're not there again. Final few notes. Please book your keys, microphones, like I said, the VGA cable, that is for your external laptop, or an audio cable via service desk. And then also this full 24-hour surveillance. What is that? Okay, there's supposed to be a surveillance camera over there. There's a surveillance camera over there. Make sure that the equipment is secured. And report, please report any damages. It's very important because we, often it's a frustration for lecturers coming to a venue, wanting to use something and it's not being fixed. You know, maybe it's been reported a week ago, because the AVS, I know the AVS guys, they don't always have the opportunity to check out all the venues in time. So the moment you come across any fault or any piece of equipment that's not operational, please report it to the AVS and they'll see to it that it's fixed within a short space of time. So maybe if you want to have, take some of those numbers down. I'm from digital media, so we do the venue training, But you know, support during lecture. For instance, if you while you're teaching, you find something is not working, the bomb suddenly goes out, over here when your microphone goes out, they just call them, the AVS guys. Technical maintenance, for instance, that maybe be the econ in this particular venue is not working. You know, and you can report to technical services, maybe there's too much dirt or the venue just hasn't been cleaned. You know, you can report it to technical services. And then also for security problems, you can call protection services. Shop that would basically allow you to do, you make use of the basic equipment that you would find in the venues. Okay? What we're going to do now is maybe just go very quickly and see the screen is going off. And you can see if I wanted to switch, I'm going to switch over to my document camera and I'm hoping that this works. It will prompt you and ask, are you sure you want to go to this? I said, touch here, yes. So now I'm switching over to the document camera. You see the lights will be immediately adjusted accordingly, and there's my document on here. Okay. So if it was a big small, you can also zoom in on certain parts of it. Again, so now you can nicely go through the presentation without having to have an OBS projector and so forth. Really nice because, like I said, you can put any particular item on the show what it is, set of keys, if you want to present. Once you're done with that, and of course, make sure before you switch over to the document camera, it's important that you first turn it on. If it's not turned on, nothing will happen. Very often, you know, AVS will call and say the document camera is not working, but the lecture just forgot to actually turn the document camera on. Yes?
It's not a support to focus button, but that doesn't focus enough. Is there another way?
study them manually. You can do a lot of focus on it. That's focusing on that. On the zoom, you know. If I'm done with my document camera, I can go back to my Crestron. Here's an exit for the door. Click on the exit button, maybe switch to lights if I wanted to override and try the lights. I can say put it to soft. Okay, there's been on. I go to PC. Okay, so adjust immediately. I go to video. This light setting is of course we wanted to go video setting. Video recording, and then I can exit that as well.
Excuse me?
Yes.
So if you have your PowerPoint presentation open and you switch over to Doc and want to go back, it quickly goes back to your last slide.
Yeah, if it's still over there, let's go back to the presentation. It's on my computer. So here, okay, I'm not on my laptop, I'll choose desktop. It takes a couple of seconds, but then we go back to it. So it's that simple. It's really, like I said, it's really designed to be intuitive, very self-explanatory. It's not really much training needed, but sometimes you find that, you know, these things get vandalized, and again, in that case, you need to report it. Your projector, again, you can turn it off once you've done. And you also have a VCR. I don't know who still use VCRs these days, but there is a VCR available if you want to make use of tape. Okay? And essentially, that is it. So I'm going to invite you all down and huddle around and see if you can manage to feel comfortable with switching between the, looking at the various aspects of the Crestron. Any questions?
Do all these cameras really work?
These, you know, I never know. The only time I find when you find out whether these cameras were working is when something's gone and you need to go to campus protection and they tell you, on that day the cameras weren't rolling.
Always wondered.
Yeah. No, so it's, you can never tell. Actually, a colleague of mine said, you know, all this stuff does is give you a false sense of security. Because you really never know if it's working or not. You know?
And also the aircon, I know they're supposed to be consistent, but I had a student walking out of class and he ended up picking up, he said it was so cold that he couldn't even remain there. And they said they would monitor or check what the temperature was. But
I think in that case you need to report it to technical services, you know.
Which I had, although it was a different number to the one
there. Is it? Yeah, the numbers, contact numbers sometimes change. But do report it to them, and if they haven't, just keep on doing it, and even if you have to go with the other guys, Frank Sam or one of these guys.
There's a carry
and
there's.
Yeah, and they need to come and check out the aircons, because definitely that one was. Okay, so you're welcome to come on down. Have a go ahead. small power.